Good day, students. Welcome to mathgotserved.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to find the domain of composite functions. All right, so let's go ahead and write down the instructions. We are to find the domain of f composed with g of x, where f of x is equal to 3 divided by x plus 2, and g of x is 4 over x. Okay? Now, before we go ahead and solve this problem, let's talk about domain real quick. Domain basically involves the set of all inputs that guarantees a defined or real output. Okay, so any input value in a function that results in an imaginary or undefined output, those values are normally excluded from the domain of the function. Okay, so for example, if you have the square root of a negative number, square root of negative, that yields an imaginary number, right? So that's imaginary. And this is normally excluded from the domain. Also, when you divide by zero, what's your answer? Division by zero results in an undefined output, so that is also excluded from the domain. So if you have a square root, let's say you have a square root of a function q, anytime you have this situation, you want to take the radicand q and set it to be greater than or equal to 0. That's how you solve for the domain involving radicals. If you have a rational expression, let's say you have p over q, what you do is you take the denominator and set it not to be equal to 0. All right? So these are basically some of the few ways of finding the domain of functions. There are other functions out there that have restriction on their domains, but these are the two common ones we're going to be focusing on. Okay, so let's take a look at this problem. Now, when you're finding the domain of a composite function, what you're going to do is you're going to find the union of two domains, okay? So the main procedure is to find the union of two things. The union of the input function g, of g, and the union of the domain of g, union of the domain of g and the domain of the composite function f of g of x. Alright, so we basically have two problems in one. First thing we're going to do is find the domain restrictions on g, and then we're going to compose these two functions and find the domain of that, then unite the two results, and that will give us our domain. Alright, so let's break it up. This is 1 and this is 2. So part 1, we're going to find the domain of the inner function, domain of g. Now, how on earth do I know that g is the inner function? Well, if you look at this notation right here, f composed with g of x, what does that mean? F composed with g of x simply means that we're taking g and plugging it into f. So this is f of g of x. So when you're finding the domain of the composition of two functions, you take the inner function g of x and find that domain first. Okay? So the inner function in this problem is 4 over x. So we need to find the domain of 4 over x. G of x is 4 over x. Now, when you're dealing with a rational function, which is a function that has a variable in the denominator, What you simply do, as indicated here, is you set the denominator equal to 0. So the denominator here is x equal to 0. So this is a restriction. This value will result in an undefined output, so x cannot be equal to 0. All right? So this is one of the restrictions in our domain. We're done with the first part, which is finding the domain of G. What are we going to do next? We're going to find the domain of f of g of x. Okay, that's what we're going to do next. All right, so in order for us to do that, we need to find what f of g of x is, okay? So we want to find the domain of the composed function f of g of x. Okay, so what is it, f of g of x? Let's go ahead and figure out what that is. F of x, the outer function is 3 divided by x plus 2. Now to find f of g, we're going to substitute the input with another function. So take out x, 3 divided by parentheses plus 2. Now let's take a minute and look at what just happened here. The outer function had x's here, and I've taken out the x's. Why did I do that? Well, because I want to find f of g of x, which is the same thing as f composed with g of x. They mean the same thing. So g is 4 over x, so we're going to put the name of the function on the left and the value of the function on the right. Okay, so this is your composed function right here. 3 divided by 4 over x plus 2. Okay, now I can simplify this further, but that's not necessary. Remember, we want to find the domain. So what is the domain of this function right here? We have a rational function, so what you do is you take the denominator, 4 over x plus 2. The denominator cannot be what? The denominator cannot be 0. Okay? So we solve this equation. That will tell us a second restriction on x that we need to consider. So here we're going to subtract 2 from both sides. Subtract 2, subtract 2. You have 4 over x equals negative 2. And then we're going to set this over 1. So we have two fractions. If you cross multiply or multiply both sides by x, you're going to end up with negative 2x equals 4. Divide both sides by negative 2. And your final answer is x equals negative 2. All right, x equals negative 2. So this is the second constraint on your domain, all right? So x cannot be negative 2, or else you have 0 in the denominator, okay? All right, so what is our final answer? Remember, we are to unite the domain of g and the domain of the composed function, okay? So we have x cannot be 0, and x cannot be negative 2. So our domain is the set x such that x cannot be negative 2, and we are finding the union here, so it's not 4, and x cannot be 0. Okay, so this is the domain of our composite function f of g of x. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. More clips can be found on mathgotserved.com. And if there are any lessons you would like us to make for you, or if you have any questions or comments, feel free to include it in the comment section below this box. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.